So my answer is based on the possibility in your school system to have career guidance or career educators that can help students track their progress by grade. So if a student in second grade demonstrates interest or at least an ability for engineering, for an example, how is that going to track then to third grade, and what should they be kind of focused on and doing, fourth grade, fifth grade, and so on. But it's a matter of kind of coordinating in the school system. I don't know if you have that ability in your school systems in the U.S. Most of them don't. And I'm hoping that maybe, okay, but it is an opportunity to take a look at how this career kind of guidance, I'm going to call it, might be able to follow students from their long-term education path to do that. Right now, there isn't a simple answer to your question. It's a great question. And being able to follow students and be able to kind of map their progress is a great idea. And the only place I've seen it happen is in schools that happen to have this career kind of function for students from ages 5 to 18.
قلنا السؤال جيد ولكن الإجابة صعبة. فحتى في كثير من المدارس في أمريكا لا يوجد تتبع الطلبة بحسب ميولهم من المراحل الأولى حتى يتخرجوا. ولكن هناك في بعض المدارس في اللي يعرفها الدكتور دوغلاس في أمريكا اللي تتابع تطور الطالب حسب ميولهم من الصف الأول ابتدائي حتى يتخرجوا، ويعملوا لهم دائما تتبع لمعرفة ما هي رغباتهم وهواياتهم وحاولوا تشجيعها وتطويرها. ويتمنى أن يوجد مثل هذا البرنامج في مدارسنا. يقول معظم المدارس في أمريكا حسب ما يعرف غير موجود، وأنا توقعاتي أنه هذا الحجر ما هو موجود في مدارسنا ولا موجود. أوكي. فجائز إنه التفكير في عمل يعني نكون جزء من خلق هذا البرنامج. بس يقول إنه الإجابة صعبة فهم فيها. طيب نود أن نشكركم جميعا لسماع للنقاش. أعتقد إنه كان في غالبه ما في شك إنه ممتع وجيد ويثير أسئلة. وهذا الآن أعتقد نهاية اليوم سيقوم الدكتور دوغلاس بتلخيص ما جرى في هذا اليوم وما سنتوقعه غدا، وسيقوم الأستاذ جمال دبل بترجمته.
So are you a little bit tired at this point? If you are, I would totally understand why. So today, I think we've had a lot of, and we have had quite a variety in our day. We've had some very good presentations this morning that have kind of given us the context of why we're here. We had, Jamal did a wonderful presentation on putting things together in a very nice kind of package and giving us some guidance on how to move forward.
يقول إن اليوم كان في تنوع كبير في الأنشطة من العروض الصباحية إلى النشاطات المختلفة بما فيها التجارب اللي تمت إقامتها، وإن شاء الله أن الجميع يعني تفاعل مع سواء العروض أو النشاطات اللي تمت.
And we had two activities that we demonstrated engineering design concepts, and we built mobiles and we built robot arms, and I hope we had some fun. I noticed a lot of clapping and laughing and learning, and I think that was a really, really positive experience. I hope that you would all agree with that. And then lastly, of course, we've had this panel session, which I hope the presentation and some of the ideas that have been generated from us and then in response to your questions has been helpful.
وأيضا كان هناك التمارين على التصميم الهندسي، وكان في تصميم للموبايل وتصميم للذراع الروبوت. فيقول كان في التفاعل والتصفيق كان قوي في بعض المراحل، بالإضافة إلى النقاش اللي اليوم تم في حلقة النقاش هذه. ويمكن لما قدمنا في البداية كان في بعض الأفكار، وأيضا خلال الأسئلة والأجوبة كان هناك تبادل للآراء.
So as we look forward to tomorrow, we have two more activities, different types of things, different concepts and challenges that we're going to do in the morning. And in the afternoon, I think you're going to be interested in this, because I had several questions from many people about what's the plan? How are we going to do this? When are we going to start? How are we going to get organized? And in the afternoon tomorrow after lunch, I believe that's the focus of what that's about. And so there'll be a lot more details shared. The plan will be outlined and described. And so I'm very much interested in listening to that, just like you are.
وبالنسبة لبكرة بيكون في تمرينين أو خطتين دراسيات زي ما صار اليوم، هذا في الفترة الصباحية. وفي الفترة المسائية بيكون الكلام على خطة العمل وما الذي سيحدث بعد كذا، وكيف بنترتب مع بعض على أساس أن ننفذ البرنامج. ويقول زي ما أنتم متشوقين أنكم تسمعون الخطة هذه وتناقشونها، هو أيضا متشوق لنفس الشيء.
So as we finish today, if you look at your tables, please leave like the tape and the scissors and some of those kinds of things there, please, because we're going to use them tomorrow. But please take your mobiles. You and your partner are going to have to, you know, decide how you're going to, who's going to take it. Take your robot arm, because if you leave it, it's going to go in the trash. And I would hate all your work to go in the trash like that. Tomorrow you're going to see a whole different set of stuff on the tables when you come in, with a whole different set of challenges that it'll have. By the way, if there are any materials that are left on the table, teachers, please take them. If there's extra robot arm kits, or if there's additional rotational equilibrium kits, take them. We want you to use them in your classroom. Please take them. I am not taking them back to the United States. Trust me. With that, I'll let Jamal translate that. I wish you a great evening, and I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow morning when we start at 8 o'clock. Thank you.
يقول بكرة في بتكون مواد جديدة وتحديات جديدة، فيقول إن أي مواد موجودة غير الموبايل ولا الروبوت آرم ممكن أن تخلونها. وقال للمعلمين أن يأخذون أي شيء متبقي على الطاولة، لأن ممكن يستفيدون منه في الفصل. فاستمتعوا بمساء مفعم بالراحة والمتعة، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
شكراً جزيلاً.